So if you start looking at a lot of the components that are the so-called active ingredients and things like echinacea and ginkgo and such, that they either have poor dosage form performance or that they undergo significant pre-systemic metabolism. Now, the dietary supplement manufacturers understand this, and there's a movement afoot to utilize more novel drug formulations out there for phytochemicals. And these are just some of the technologies that are out there: liposomes, phytosomes, self-emulsifying drug delivery systems, nanoparticles, and actually the purposeful integration of things like piperine into the formulations to inhibit some of these drug metabolizing enzymes that will allow other phytochemicals to be metabolized. We're almost finished here. So I just want to use one of these technologies to illustrate this point, and that's with liposomes. And liposomes, if you're not familiar, they're basically like lipid nanobubbles, all right? And they allow drug molecules to be taken up into the bubbles, and they can improve their aqueous solubility, and they can also improve their permeability. One of the shortcomings with liposomes is that they have a relatively short shelf life, but there are no commercially available products on the market now, but I know there are some under development. So anyway, to get to the point, this is the milk thistle, and milk thistle is notorious for having poor oral bioavailability. And so this is a dissolution profile for milk thistle in a classic or a conventional capsule. This is a liposomal formulation. So you can see a dramatic improvement in the dissolution profile for the silymarin components in milk thistle. And that certainly translates into a dramatic improvement in the bioavailability. So at least with liposomes, you may not only improve the efficacy of milk thistle, which is a good thing, but then you may also increase the toxicity or maybe the herb-drug interaction possibilities, right? So there's very few randomized controlled clinical trials done with these novel formulations, and there's virtually no herb-drug interaction studies done. All right, so to conclude, certainly botanicals can interact with conventional medications. The mechanisms may be dynamic or kinetic in mechanism. Thankfully, the vast majority of popular botanicals, at least in the dosage forms that are on the market now, pose very little risk for herb-drug interactions. But then again, there's a wide variety of others out there on the market that have never been tested. All right, so. And then these novel dosage forms they might improve the efficacy, but they might also increase the risk of interaction. So with that, I appreciate your attention, and I'll be happy to answer any questions. Thank you.